Hello, and welcome to Timberdoodle's Custom Scheduler. We're going to jump right in here. To set up your schedule, go to scheduler.timberdoodle.com. If you've used the scheduler before or have a timberdoodle.com account, enter that information here. If not, take a moment to sign up. Once you do that, you'll be prompted to log in with your username or email address and password. If your purchased curriculum was not added to your account automatically, just click Use Your Code. You'll be prompted to enter both your order number and the code found in your handbook. On the Edit Schedule screen, enter your student's name. This is also used as the name of the schedule, so feel free to use first name only, your child's nickname, or even something as customized as Joe's School with Grandma, if you prefer. Choose the date you want to schedule to start. I'm going to start August 1st. Next, note whether or not you want the curriculum scheduled Monday through Friday. If no, you'll be given the option to select which days you want to schedule. I'm going to go with Monday through Thursday. Saturday and Sunday will be added as options later this year. You can schedule by the number of weeks you want to do school, or create your schedule with an end date. We're going to end the Friday before Memorial Day. Decide whether or not you want to schedule any curriculum breaks. It may be helpful to note that breaks do not change your school weeks or end date. It just moves the assignments off the break and redistributes them onto the other school days. I'm going to put in a break for the week of Thanksgiving, then 2 weeks for Christmas, and another week after New Year's Day. And let's put in a long weekend break at the end of September. Once you have this page set up the way you want it, click Save and Continue. This will take you to the first curriculum subject, Language Arts. If everything looks good, of course, there is no need to edit it, but we are going to delete and add some courses to show you how you'd go about doing that. The first course is all about Reading 3. Click Edit. Here, we can decide how often we want to include this course and how we want it scheduled. That all looks good, so click Save and go back to the curriculum page. Let's look at Daily 6, Straight Writing. Click Edit. Let's backload the units on this one. That means that the units will all be scheduled towards the end of the year, rather than evenly spread throughout the year. We're going to use Lost Trail for fun reading instead of assigning it, so we can delete that one from the checklist. Now, let's take a look at Overview under Language Arts to take a look at our schedule. That looks good. Let's move on to Math. We need a different level of math, so let's delete both of these items. That removed the math subject entirely from the left sidebar. No worries. Here's how we can add math back in. Scroll down to click on Add Course. Since I didn't mean to delete math, I'm going to add in a placeholder course to get us back on track. For the course name, I'll put in Oops. Then scroll down to select Math as the course subject. I'll need to put something in the unit type field, so I'm just going to put in Pages. It doesn't really matter since this is just going to be a temporary placeholder. Then Save. Then Save and Continue. Now Math shows up with our Oops course on the Schedule Summary page, but it's still not showing up on the left sidebar. So we'll go back out to the dashboard, click on Edit Schedule, and when we come back in, there is math in the sidebar where it belongs. And there's our Oops course. What I actually need is Math UC Alpha. So I'll go up to Add Additional Courses, find the Alpha level and click Add, then Save. Now I can delete the Oops course. The math schedule looks good so far. Let's add some subtraction wrap-ups. I'm just going to schedule those once a week, on Wednesdays, spread throughout the year. We'll check to make sure the math schedule looks good, then move on to geography. I'm going to put in a long mid-year break for the geo puzzles. And save. Geography schedule overview looks okay. On to science. I want to add our science lab group to the schedule, So I'll click on Add Additional Course and put in Science Lab Group for the course name. Course subject is science. Unit type will be session. We'll meet with our group weekly, one time a week, on Tuesday. I'm also going to add an additional course for 1,000 hours outside. This will help ensure we are getting those hours in every day. Course subject will be PE. Unit type is hour. I'll set the number of units to 1,000 and spread evenly throughout the year. Save. I don't think I need to make any other changes, but I'll check my schedule summary just to make sure. Yes, that all looks good. So I'll save and continue. Go to Dashboard, and we're all set up.